This podcast has been brought to you by Seeker's Guidance, the global Islamic seminary. Help us spread the light of prophetic guidance to millions around the world by becoming a monthly supporter. Make a small donation at seekersguidance.org/donate. For as little as $10 a month, you can help people find life-changing guidance.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah. قيوم السماوات والأراضين مدبر الخلائق أجمعين باعث الرسل رحمة للعالمين اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وسلِّم تسليماً كثيراً. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. We find ourselves in a month of gratitude, the month of Ramadan that has just begun. And this month can be a very busy month for us because we may be juggling between work and family and the social responsibilities of this month of Ramadan, which are beautiful responsibilities of iftar, of having family over, of going to family iftars, and iftars with friends, iftars in the community. And then the beauty of the Taraweeh prayer at night, and the other devotions at night, and then getting up early for our suhoor. So it can be a very busy month. It can be, as a result, a stressful month for us. But one of the gifts of this month should be the very opposite of feeling busy and stressed, which is to find calm and serenity in this month of Ramadan. To find calm and serenity in this month of Ramadan. Because it is from that calm and serenity that one reaches contentment. And it is from contentment that one reaches a sense of presence with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to worship Him with sincerity, ikhlas. But what is sincerity? It's ikhlas. For water to be pure, is for it to be free of anything that stirs it up. When water is still, like if you have a pond of water, and some of you are from lands where you have many pools and ponds of water, and if you notice water, when it's still, the sediment goes to the bottom, and the water becomes clean. When it's stirred up, it becomes murky. Sincerity itself, which is how we're supposed to worship Allah, ikhlas, is for the water to be freed from everything that roils it up. But it takes effort. It takes effort. Similarly, certitude, yaqeen, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to have faith with yaqeen, with certitude. What is yaqeen? Certitude. Yaqeen is again from when water is still. يَقَنَ الْمَاءِ إِذَا سَكَنْ وَلَمْ يَتَحَرَّقْ. Water has yaqeen when it is still and is not shaken up. And that's how our faith should be. That our faith is unshakable. But it comes from what? From reaching that place of serenity and calm. That whatever happens, our faith is not shaken. Our religious practice is not shaken. Our relationship with Allah is not shaken. How do we achieve that? We should practice it in this month. Because though we have many things by day and by night that busy us. Right? Getting up for suhoor time. Practice that serenity. Practice that calm. It can be difficult to wake up your family at that time because they came back from Taraweeh and they had the third round of desserts. They got this big sugar rush. Now they're deeply asleep and you're waking them up for suhoor. It can really be easy to feel rushed and busied and shaken up. But all of those hurt us in fulfilling the aims of this month, which is to cultivate those states of calm, of acquiring sincerity, of acquiring certitude, yaqeen, which are all from reaching a place of stillness and calm, from which certitude arises. What is certitude? That our faith is not shaken. So we should embrace that. That yes, we have a rush at Fajr. We have 23 minutes to wake up everyone and put some liquid and some calories into the family members. And sometimes you feel like you have to open their mouths and kind of say, okay, have something. But whatever it is, let's just embrace a little bit of calm with that. Similarly, it can be stressful to get to work and get back to work. And will I get home in time? And will I get the groceries in time? And will the food delivery arrive in time? And all the busyness of life and its challenges. Getting our prayers in at work may challenge us and stress us. Juggling so many different things and we may feel tired and exhausted. Our blood sugar levels may be going all over the place as a result of the challenge of the fast. But in all of this, let us strive to embrace calm and to find the serenity and to see with our faith, with clarity. How do we do that? They say it is a moment of calm and clarity before. Why? Because you have to wake up your children or your spouse or you yourself have to wake up. You have to eat. So whatever you do, you have to do it anyways. But if you don't have to do it, don't do it. Your 22-year-old is an adult. If you realize, okay, I don't want to wake them up, don't. It's on them. It's not fard to get up for suhoor. It's sunnah. And it's on them, really. You're just helping. It's recommended for you to help them fulfill a sunnah. But if you choose to do it with calm. Choose to do it with calm. And this is difficult. Because that is part of the journey of faith. And if we do that, we will open our hearts, our souls, our beings, to really benefit from the fast. Especially if we consider prophetic teachings. Your uncle insisted on you having a little more dessert and a cup of tea before you headed out. And then you didn't find your parking spot here at IMO. So you're running late. But you're running late anyways. But just practice a little bit of calm. Take a deep breath and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you're going to get there whenever you're going to get there. Practice that calm. You're wondering that, okay, tomorrow I have an important meeting. I hope you don't on a Saturday, but let's say Sunday night, Monday morning. So, okay, do I stay for the rest of the Taraweeh prayer or not? Very often we stress ourselves so much that we're not actually thinking about the prayer. You're wondering, Raka'ah 9, will I join the congregation or not? Whatever decision you're going to make, embrace calm. Because what you're doing is an act of drawing closer to Allah. You're performing a sunnah. You fulfilled your obligation for the day. You've done the fast. You've done your 5 prayers. Now, the Taraweeh is a beautiful voluntary act. It's an act of drawing closer to Allah. It's an act of love. My servant, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Hadith Qudsi, words inspired to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my servant draws close to me by nothing more beloved to me than what I've made obligatory upon them. And my servant continues to draw close to me by voluntary works, by the nawafil, until I love them. Until I love them. So this is a voluntary act. It's a beautiful act, a beloved act. Allah has granted you facilitation to do it. So don't approach it with this, with stress, with feeling overwhelmed. Whatever you're able to do, do it. But with calm, with contentment, with joy. You're running late for Taraweeh because you had to pick up one of your family members from the GO station because they're working late, or they're downtown at university, or whatever it may have been. Now you're running late for the masjid. Stressing won't magically get you there faster. There aren't the malaika of stress. And Sheikh Abdullah could confirm that. There's no malaika of stress. That if you're stressed enough, the malaika will say, okay, the ETA to such and such mosque will go from being 17 minutes to 11 minutes. It won't happen normally. Some miracles can happen in our lives, but you can't expect miracles day to day. So okay, you're running late. You have the intention. You have the intention. So don't stress. You got there on time to catch Maghrib prayer at the masjid, which is a beautiful thing. And many masajid, and especially this, have beautiful iftar programs. And the most important of which is the Maghrib prayer itself. So you're running late. Okay. Remember that Allah rewards us on the basis of our intention. Even if you're running late for Jumu'ah, what do we do? The Prophet ﷺ tells us, إِذَا أُقِيمَتِ الصَّلَاةِ, even if the prayer begins, فَمْشُوا إِلَيْهَا بِالسَّكِينَةِ وَالْوَقَارِ, walk to it with calm and dignified serenity, dignified restraint, وَقَار. And وَقَار, what is it again? It's a water concept. وَقَرَ الْمَاء إِذَا سَكَن. Water, like the calm dignity, وَقَار, is when the water is still. The Arabs had very little water in the desert, so they paid a lot of attention to water. And a lot of the key concepts of our religion revolve around water. Sincerity is water to be still and pure. Yaqeen, certainty, is when the water is still and calm and unshakable because it's become deep and wide. Likewise, waqa, sakina, serenity, which is a high religious quality, sakina or sukoon, is for the water to be still. Dignified restraint, which is how we act on the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, waqar, is when the water is still and unshaken. And very often waqar relates to when the water flows, but it flows calmly. So even if you're running late for Jummah, what do? You don't speed. Of course, you don't go extra slow, but you don't rush. When you park properly. When you walk to the masjid, you walk purposefully, but calmly and with dignity. Why? Because we worship a merciful Lord. You had the intention to be on time, but you took a wrong turn. You didn't deliberately take a wrong turn. Now don't stress, because you're going to get there when you will get there. And maybe next time you learn, then keep following the GPS. Or if you're given to take wrong turns, like my friend and I, he was trying to drop me home a couple of days ago. It's a 12-minute route, it took 30 minutes. Because he was stressed and he kept taking wrong turns, even though he probably dropped me 50 times. Stress won't get anything better. So okay, we have to turn right, and he turned left. They said, okay, we have to turn left, you turn right. Okay. What do we do next? Right, so embrace this calm. The guests are late. And if they arrive late, then the food will be served late, then you'll be late. Okay. Don't worry, rather wonder, what do I do next? What do I do next? You messed up. You got upset with the guests. And it happens. People like me have to mediate a lot of these disputes in Ramadan. People get upset. The caterers are late. They've been serving food at the masjid for 25 years. And how could you be late with the first iftar of the year? But they are. Getting worried won't change how soon they come. Getting upset with them won't serve the food faster. But what we can do, if we embrace calm, we can respond in a good way. It's okay, let's serve extra water. Let's serve the drinks that we're going to serve at Taraweeh time. Let's give a little presentation, do something or the other. But let's embrace calm. Similarly, within the prayer, within our acts of worship, a lot of people get frantic. What else can I do? No, approach your religion with that sense of calm. How much Quran do I recite? Approach it with a position of calm, of contentment. Why? Because what is it that you're doing? You are worshipping Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. You're worshipping Allah, who is the all-merciful and the particularly caring. So if you stop for a moment and wonder, what exactly am I trying to do? Why am I? You're worried about, okay, this is day two. I haven't started my routine of Quran. Don't approach it with this sense of stress and worry. Take a deep breath. Feel that calm and serenity and contentment and joy. Allah has placed in your heart a care and concern to recite His book. So begin from that position of calm, of gratitude. Connect things to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know Him to be the all-merciful. Say, okay. And then if you have, instead of worry, you have concern, you say, okay, I want to recite the Qur'an. I have a routine of completing the Qur'an once, twice, however much you recite it in Ramadan. Say, okay, I need to do two juz a day and a little more to catch up on these 2 days that I've been late with. What do I do about it? And that's one of the ways that we can embrace calm and that way cultivate our faith through these things that we're doing rather than making this a frantic month. And the key to that calm is to connect things to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before you respond, take a deep breath and think that this is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what do I do about it? The Prophet ﷺ tells us, كُلُّ ابْنِ آدَمَ خَطَّاءٌ. All the children of Adam are very erring, make numerous mistakes. وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. And the best of those who err are those who are oft repentant. We have an elderly relative in our family who's very sick. So their daughter made them lentil soup. And I can tell you their daughter cooks really well. But whenever their parent is sick, they get very grumpy. So I said, were lemons on discount? Was there a 2-for-1 sale for lemons? Because you put so much lemon in the lentil soup, it tasted like lemon juice with some lentils in it. Okay, they've said it. Now, what do you do about it? And what do you do about it? Take a deep breath and respond in a way that will be pleasing to Allah. But maybe tired, hungry, stressed, you may respond in a wrong way. But then, okay, you made one mistake. But it's better to make one mistake than two. So you messed up, but then on top of it, you go all negative. I messed up. No, even when you mess up, and mess up you will. In your deen, you will mess up. In your relationships, you will mess up. In your worldly life, you will mess up. What do? خَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. The best of those who err are the oft-repentant. All you have to do is sincerely repent. Seek Allah's forgiveness.
And whatever needs rectifying, rectify. Apologize. Apologize. Follow a bad deed with a good, and it will wipe it out. As our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said,
you messed up with respect to the fast. Fasting is supposed to control our desires, but some people find, people have different temperaments. The tabar of people differs. Some people find that their desires are stirred up in the month of Ramadan, and you're struggling. Of course, that's one of the wisdoms why we should fast outside the month of Ramadan as well. So we're used to fasting, so we can control our hunger and other desires outside the month of Ramadan, so the fasting doesn't overwhelm us nor surprise us. But you messed up. What do you do? A believer does not worry. We have concern, which is something that is not pleasing to us. We connect it with a plan of future action. Whether you messed up in your religion, you messed up in a relationship, you messed up in some worldly decision. You told your boss that he's a complete loser, that this is all tokenism that you're doing. You put up a slogan that Ramadan Mubarak, but you don't hire Muslims. And you know it because now your boss felt guilty. She didn't fire you, but your job is now even more at line. So what do? You don't worry. You don't worry. What is Iman? Iman is to have the coolness of certitude that things are in the hands of Allah. And what do I do next? What do I do next? That is how we try to embrace calm and bring increasing calm. All of us have turbulence in our lives. We are created to toil and struggle in this life. We all have our toils. We all have our struggles. If you don't think you have tests and tribulations in your life, then the very fact that you don't think you have tests and tribulations is itself a test and a tribulation. Because when you know I have six problems, you know what you have to respond to as a servant of God. When you think everything is completely fine, maybe you're not seeing the test that you have in your life. Because the test of ease is more difficult than the test of difficulty. The test of plenty is more difficult than the test of hardship. So you take a deep breath and wonder, okay, how do I turn and return to Allah where I am? So in this month, let us embrace calm in the rush of this month. Let us embrace contentment as we go through our acts of worship, of devotion, and our social duties in this month. Take a deep breath and do all these things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Feel the mercy of Allah. Feel the care of Allah. Feel the blessing of Allah. And have gratitude to Allah in this month. This shouldn't be a month where we're frowning. And alhamdulillah, there's many people here who are smiling. Alhamdulillah. Thumma alhamdulillah. But very often, many people look, even at Salat al-Jum'ah, as if like they're being put in the grave themselves. The believer, even if you're being put in the grave, you died on La ilaha illallah. Would your soul be frowning when you go in the grave? No. Even if the last breath we're taking as a believer, we take it with a smile. Because if you die on La ilaha illallah, you end in Jannah. So what is the big worry? Even when you mess up, you feel bad that you messed up. But you feel joy that you are a servant of the All-Merciful. You repent. Allah has promised that He will wipe out your sin. هُوَ الَّذِي يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ It is He alone who accepts the repentance of His servants. People usually don't accept your apology. You're seeking forgiveness from them. But our Lord is Al-Akram. He is the most noble, the most generous. He'll unconditionally accept you. So return to Him with calm, contentment, and joy. Embrace that in this month. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم.
Thank you for listening. This podcast was brought to you by Seekers Guidance, the Global Islamic Seminary. Visit seekersguidance.org to access reliable Islamic knowledge taught by qualified teachers. We offer a wide range of courses, podcasts, articles, and a world-class answer service. Support us in spreading free, reliable Islamic knowledge to millions around the world by becoming a monthly supporter. Visit seekersguidance.org/donate and make a small monthly commitment today. Our beloved Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, said, "Whoever guides someone to goodness will have a similar reward." So don't forget to share this podcast and spread prophetic guidance.